Okay, now I'm always talking about suspension travel, you know, and I go over this over and over again. There's an old saying, it's not how much you have, it's how good it is or what you do with it. Well, you know, that really comes from suspension travel. And I learned this long time ago from the guru of suspension and off-road ATVs, Doug Roll. It's not how much suspension travel you have, it's how much of it you use and how good it is. So it doesn't matter if you've got 12 inches of suspension travel, if you've got it so stiff and so bound up that you only use 3 inches of it. So this is where I say, one of the things to get more suspension travel out of your IRS suspension system is to remove the sway bar. Now, IRS, by the way, stands for independent rear suspension. Sway bar, by definition, connects the two together, connects the left side and the right side together so that when one starts to move, oh, it's no longer independent, but it starts to pull the other one up. So it limits the wheel travel. Yes, indeed, it does make it more stable in high speed situations, but it really limits the travel and the softness of the suspension when you're just out on the trail riding. So we're gonna just show the difference on my King Quad 750 here with the sway bar connected and with the sway bar disconnected. So we'll see what kind of difference we have on my little homemade articulation rim. All right, King, back it up here and we'll see what happens. What we'll do is we'll back it up until the one wheel comes off the ground. Right there, it looks like, yep, right there. Okay, now with Kenny's weight, you can see how this is going. We've now got the front really in a bind, but the back, you can see, has not moved that much. So I'm gonna do a couple things here. I'm gonna put a piece of tape right where this went. So we can see, measure that, and then, you know, you can see how far this thing is off of the ground and how the front is. Then what we're gonna do right now is just take a break, stick it in the shop, disconnect the rear sway bar, and then we're gonna back it right up here and here again. So let's do that. Okay, so now we've taken the sway bar off, which is, you know, a little link. You've gotta disconnect each link on each A-arm and then the bar itself across the back. Not that difficult, but you do really, to do it right, you gotta take the rear tires off to get in there and get that all done. So now let's see what kind of difference it made. So we've made it up past the ramp. We're on the ramp now, and it's still not lifting the front wheel off. So I guess we could have made the ramp steeper. Or for now, I can just show you how much further we get, and you can look at the difference right here on how much more difference in the travel there is on the wheels. Take a quick look. At least by shutting that off, at least I can talk now without trying to talk over the side of the engine. So you can see that it's got a lot more flex to it, which really makes a difference going over the irregularities, the bumps and the ruts and the rocks. The downside, if you would call it a downside, is that you're going to feel the machine lean. You can feel it when you're turning. You can feel it lean over, which can be disconcerting at first, but once you get used to it, you realize it's not going to go anyplace. In fact, when you feel that lean over, a lot of times in sharper corners, you can actually feel it loading the outside rear tire for more grip because you're putting that much more weight on it. So, like I say, a little bit more nervous until you put a few miles on it, but after you do that, I think you're going to be in love with it. And it's one of those things that if you don't like it, you know, and it does scare you and you don't like that added comfort and softness in the suspension, you can always put it back on. So that's it. You know, to me, I kind of relate it to a lot of the people that are nervous about doing this. I go, look at, well, first of all, look at off-road racing. Or, no, let's look at off-road rock crawling. Do they use sway bars? No. Let's look at road racing. Do they use, they do use sway bars. That's right. So on the road for flat cornering, on blacktop at high speed, they use sway bars. For off-road extreme rock crawling, they don't use sway bars. And then so I use always as the analogy, take a look at like a trophy truck or something. You see a trophy truck coming around the corner, and it's coming around the corner, and it's leaning way over and actually lifting that inside front wheel on that turn, which is awesome to look at, probably scary for those guys, and something that you need to be aware of. But overall, it's going to make your ride, especially for trail riding and rough trails, it's going to make it way better. And we have now done this to the King Quads, the Brute Force, the TRX, the Razors. I think that's, and the Polaris Tourings that we had, we've done it to all of those, and we've been in love with it. So hey, that's it. I'm gonna pull this down now that I've got it disconnected, and go for a ride on some rough trail and be comfortable. Hey, see you next time. Till then, God bless.